Half man, half machine, whoa! All cop.
Whoa, look at that thing! It's a gigantic metal fist, which is something I've always wanted to have grafted to me.
In studio, we have the Maryland State Fire Marshal. It is the Department of State Police. We have Detective Dale Ednock. We have Deputy Chief Jack Waldner and Detective William Potts. And they have brought with them one of the robots. Last Thursday, here on TV Hill, there was an incident at Fox 45. Gentleman claimed to have a bomb. It ended up being chocolate bars and a smoke detector.
Still waiting to find out what was in that chocolate.
But you got to be careful. You can't, you know, you got to assume everything's a bomb. So they brought out a robot and they ripped the guy's clothes off with the robot. And then the robot took the clothes off to the side where it could be inspected.
Sanchez, deploy the robot and get this guy naked.
Josh Spiegel getting dressed in the bomb suit. We're going to get into that in a little bit.
Just one thing. The Velcro front seems to be expanding because I'm very large.
Yeah, you're not really fitting into the suit.
Yeah, that Velcro's.
And how do you feel having three men around you dressing you in this thing?
And you're not even in Miami.
Oh, is this the diaper part? Look, they got a bomb-proof diaper. Oh my God, that goes right over his crotch and right around his waist.
Oh wow, it does go over his crotch.
Look at that. You gotta protect. I guess you gotta protect everything. You know, you gotta protect that part too.
I think
too.
He might take that home.
The Velcro just bust. The Velcro just bust. Oh, Spiegel is... tilt your head. It's going to fall off.
How much does that helmet weigh?
Not as much as his head.
About 13 pounds.
13 pounds.
13-pound helmet. And I'm surprised the helmet fit, because Spiegel has a gigantic head. Nothing ever fits Spiegel.
Look at those two guys trying to get that helmet around his head. You can get that helmet around a stop sign.
One of them, as he was putting the helmet on my head, he said, "Oh, my God."
He was like... It looks like Roger Ramjet. People my age will remember the cartoon Roger Ramjet. That's
Spiegel
what he looks like.
Spiegel is basically...
Small body, big head.
There's size adjustments inside there. Obviously, we got to make them.
Did they just quit on trying to get the helmet on top of him? Did they bail?
This is the fourth adjustment they're making. They're widening the helmet.
I mean, do you have to take the padding out of that thing?
They're going to need to blast...
Josh literally has the biggest head.
Yeah. Yeah. Josh is basically like a human equivalent of Shrek.
Not a big ego,
pretty much
a big head.
Outside of the mystical backstory in the swamp village. There we go.
There we
We're
go.
Trying to get this bomb. Look, he's got to pin down his ears. Oh, it fit. I think it fit.
Oh.
It fit?
No. It's still not fitting.
There you go.
So this is it. Now
I'm
going
to have to talk really loud. I have never seen this before.
I've never seen this before. It just won't fit on his head.
Most of our rookies, we have to do skull measurements.
Okay.
So now, dressing Josh. Here, Josh. Why don't you come over to the microphone. Now, it's taking a long time, right? Obviously, because it's a very intricate suit. It's got a lot of zippers and a lot of buckles. But is it a little harder dressing him? It seems like you're having a more difficult time. Obviously, with the helmet, with this Velcro, or is it normally this labor-intensive?
It's usually a lot quicker, but, I mean, this suit is actually sized for, like, me. I mean, this is my suit.
So,
I mean,
that's your suit.
They're small, medium, larges, extra larges, so, I mean,
what size is that suit?
This is a medium, actually.
Oh, we're putting him in a medium.
It's hard stuffing that much excellence into it.
It would be a medium for me. I think today we'll call it a schmedium.
Okay. Yeah, because I noticed it seemed like you guys were struggling a little bit.
All right, so what's going on now? Looks like they're putting on the front of the suit.
Whoa, man. Look at the arm. Look at the control pad on the arm.
Look at the size of that.
Oh, we got to get into this thing. So this is what is the suit called?
Whoa.
This is it's again a Canadian company, and it is MedEng is the name of the company, and their number 9 edition of this suit.
Now, what type of explosion?
The Velcro belt just snapped.
Could this handle?
The Velcro.
About 9 pounds of explosives at about 10 feet is survivable in this suit.
Wow!
Oh, no kidding.
There's no way he's getting in there. He can't hear anything. Oh my God! They are struggling to get
the
suit on.
So what is the material inside the coat that makes it?
Really, there's outer ballistic shields.
Okay.
But the inside is the same as the soft body armor, only more layers. This has about 36 layers of Kevlar.
Wow. I imagine this is what Josh.
36.
This is what Josh went through on his prom night, getting dressed. There was like two people and a guidance counselor behind him.
Let's say like a regular bulletproof vest. How many layers of Kevlar is that?
Like 8.
And this is 36 layers, just to put it in perspective.
Roughly. Man. Some are different, depending on the mission, right, some are different, but roughly speaking.
Now, Jack, while he finishes getting in this suit here right now, they're going to finish getting him all outfitted and set up. We've still got the robot over there, and you have the control panel?
I do.
Okay, I would love to do maybe take this thing through its paces real quick. I got a piece of chicken. All right, and is there any way we can get this thing to maybe like grip this thing and feed it to me, or maybe throw it at Mike or something?
Well, I got.
Oh wow! Look at Josh; he's done.
Yeah.
Oh, look at the fog. He can't see anything.
Let's just finish up with Spiegel here. How's it feel?
What?
How does it feel?
It's not bad.
Can you see anything?
It's a little snug, but.
Why is it fogging up? Is that normal?
Normally, we'll have a power pack.
Oh, they've got a fan. Like, there's an AC that's normally.
Oh, yeah, look. Spiegel, turn around. There's an XLR cable in the back of that thing, the same type of thing we use to hook up microphones.
Oh, my God.
So what this does, there's a power pack, and we'll plug this in the helmet, and the helmet has built-in fans, so it actually channels cool air over.
Yeah,
number one,
that.
To keep you cool, and two, to clear when that does.
Well, because what was the movie, The Hurt Locker, yes, right? Isn't that the famous movie, The Hurt Locker?
Yeah, Jeremy Renner.
It is.
He's in the bomb suit. I mean, that's... Yeah, I think that was the biggest way people were exposed
you've
to the bomb.
You've also got hearing protection in there, and you've got the communication system.
I didn't even think about hearing.
Blow your eardrums out. Something goes off close to you.
Oh, my God.
Right. Normally, we have somebody trying out for the squad.
Here, get close to this.
We'll have to do is we put them in the suit. Then we lay them on their back, and you have to be able to get up.
Josh, no way.
That's one of the basic.
Lay down and try to get up.
He can't even get up without a suit on.
Well, his credit,
exactly. For real.
Awful small.
Yeah. Okay. What is the control controls on the arm? Did you see the control pad?
Yeah, this is what controls your fan, your lights, in the suit itself.
Look at that.
And your volume.
And your comms.
And what's volume. A suit like that? All things total running us.
$28,000.
$28,000.
So tired right now.
Why? You didn't do anything.
So you could either get like a tricked out Sonata or one of these.
Yeah.
Now imagine putting that on and having to go defuse a bomb.
Yeah.
Right. Think about that for hours.
I really want you to lie down and try and get up.
I can't hear you.
Can you lie down on the ground and attempt to get up? Because I want to watch you flail comically.
Just go down. Okay. Go down to your knees.
Yeah, go down, Josh. Oh!
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, oh, my God.
Oh yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, he's so
oh. Oh.
Did he fall or did he lay down?
He fell. That is definitely.
You can do it. How am I going to get up?
You can do it. You got the right technique. That's
he's
it. Roll over.
Up.
I've fallen and
he's
I can't
never
get up.
You got it, Josh.
We gotta help him.
No, he needs to do it on his own. He has to learn.
You can be a bomb squad guy. Not really.
I would never say that.
Here, I'm gonna hand this T-800, this chicken cutlet of mine.
Okay.
All right, go ahead and give it a grip. Whoa, it's go!
All right, man. Smush the chicken a little, but hey, it's still there.
Imagine if that was a certain part of you. All right, now I'm gonna back up.
Oh, okay. you're gonna make it hard for him?
Give me some chicken.
Here he goes. The robot is now advancing forward. Why don't you like bend down or get like in a weird position so he doesn't have to.
There you go. Try to get that chicken.
Okay. The robot is now advancing. He's panning the arm down. Look at, just don't move your. It's in.
The precision. A six-figure piece of technology to feed me breakfast.